digitalization is not prevalent. Technology is in schools. So how can teachers keep up to date with what is changing and update their competencies?
According to my experience, I think there are three main scenarios. The first scenario is the school. So we need to understand that in the school, teachers can teach the teachers. So it's very interesting to take advantage of the knowledge of our own teachers to teach the teachers. Second scenario is when we can send the teachers to learn to different organizations, institutions, or via online. It's away from the school, but it's a good place for learning this kind of new technologies. And the third scenario is the company. I think we need to trust more in the companies. And vocational schools have to make an investment investment in time, investment in the budget, to send the teachers to other companies to learn about these new technologies, and also how we have to apply these new technologies and digitization in the real world when they are working.
And you also said that teachers can create, and they do create, a learning environment. This sounds great, but how do they do that?
Teachers, in former days, maybe they were containers of knowledge. As much masters you have, better teacher you are. But this is not up to date. So now a teacher must be able, as you said, to create learning environments. And this is the new profession of the teacher. But how to do it? I think they need also to work in a team. Work in a team, probably, if we are talking in vocational education, I think internationalization is a good measure to try to reach this objective. If we create, for example, international technical departments where the teachers can share their knowledge, share their experiences, good practices, bad practices, within professionals in education in different countries, I think this is a good measure we can take, a good action to train our teachers in this field of creating new scenarios of learning.
You are a school leader yourself because you are a director of a vocational school in Valencia in Spain.
Yeah.
And you won an award in last year's European Vocational Skills Week in Vienna. Yeah. What was this award about?
The European Commission saw some characteristics of our school that I think are attractive for education. The first one is that we have developed a new pedagogy. So, yeah, and the teachers have been involved in this new pedagogy. We call it working on projects with X at the end, and the students are really the protagonists of their own learning process. The second factor is that our school is also very international. So we operate at very international level. We receive students from many different countries, and we send teachers and students. Our teachers travel every year, all of them. So not only to Europe, because we have a good relationship with America, because we speak the same language, we have this international agreement with some countries in America. There are other factors. I think the teachers have their own personal development plan, evaluation, quality questionnaires. For example, in our school, students can evaluate every single lesson of the teachers. Students and teachers can evaluate every day my job, that I am the principal. So we have lost fear to be evaluated, so to discover failures. Because to be innovative, you need failures. It's the best mechanism to improve a person and to improve an institution.